What's up, you guys? I know tonight we were supposed to have emerging leaders training, but I made a decision to make this our tips from the top tonight because it was just on my heart. It's so crazy. Like, you know, God just dropped your name, like literally just dropped it on my heart and was like, reach out, have her do a tips from the top for your team. And I'm like, oh, okay. And I've never really heard your full story. I think I've heard bits and pieces, but I've never heard the full story. But I want to say that it has just been an honor to know you over all these years. And you don't have to tell me if I'm saying your name right. I believe it's Mirlane. Is it Mirlane? Is that how I say it? Because that's how I've been saying it all these years. But is that right?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. So I'm going to tell you guys, grit, determination, such vigor, such so beautiful. Such courage, just a dog, like just want to go at it and go get it no matter what. And so I want you to talk today, and of course, giving you full permission to be fully you. But I want to start off with just having you introduce yourself. Tell us a little bit about your story. And let me bring you up so the people can know who in the world I am talking about. Y'all give her some love in the comments for being on with us on today. I want you to share a little bit about your story, why you said yes to It Works, how It Works found you, and let's just start there. So let's talk about before It Works, how It Works found you, and why you said yes, and how you said yes. How did you come to find It Works?
Sure. Hi, everyone. My name is Mirlane Bashat. My kids are home, so you guys excuse if you hear noise. I do have three children. I'm gonna go into details with that. So I am originally from Haiti, and I grew up in New Jersey, and I'm now in South Carolina. I've been married to my husband for, it'll be 19 years in this year, November. How before It Works, my husband and I, we were struggling with fertility issues. We're married. And it just took us about 7 years to have our first child. I don't know if any of you, I know Rachel went through some of that, but it was so crazy. You know, we prayed and prayed and prayed. Finally, God blessed us with our first baby. And I didn't think I was going to have any more children because I'm like, okay, we struggled so much. And then after the first baby came, I was a social worker for 15 years. And after the first baby came, I was so excited to go back to work to share my joy and my bundle of joy. Then soon after, I got pregnant again. I'm like, what in the world? Like, how did it happen? But so when my second baby came, it was so hard for me to go back to work. It's like transitioning from the first child to the second. It was really, really challenging. So I found myself on social media, and as I nursing this baby would not, this is the second child, and she would not sleep for months straight, and I don't know what was wrong with her, but she wouldn't sleep. And I was like, I was scrolling on social media, and I saw a friend of mine posting about working from home and things. I'm like, oh, what if I could work from home and still be home with my baby? And so I called her up. She said, did I want to sign up to be a customer? I said, no, I want to make some money. I was one of those. I was not skeptical. I was just like, just sign me up, whatever it is. I just want to be home. So I signed up. That was 2014, December 8, 2014. I'll never forget that day. And then so I did go back to work, but I was still having trouble with just trying to get daycare and all of that. And 2 years in, 2016, you know, I decided to go ahead, and it was just too challenging. Two children. And the thing is, as a social worker where I used to work, I was dealing with people who did not want their kids. I used to take their kids and put them in foster care and things like that because they were not qualified, or, you know, things that, and I couldn't have any children. Now I remember one lady, she kept saying, well, you're going to keep taking them and I'm going to keep having more. And then I went home that day and cried so much. I said, Lord, I want a baby so bad. And then hear this lady saying that I'm going to keep having babies and you're going to keep taking them and I'm not able to have children. So I cried and cried. Then so I came home to be with my baby 2016, and I haven't been back to work. I have not returned back to work. I've been with the company since 2014, came home in 2016. Do you want me to go into my journey with everything or?
Sure, go right ahead. You flowing.
So, and I just, the reason why I'm sharing these, because trust your process, because December 8th, 2024, it will be 10 years here. And I know, happy anniversary to Rachel. Today is her 11th year, and she's an ambassador, I think 2.0, right? You and your 2.0 account. Yes. And I have not reached ambassador yet, right? So congratulations to Rachel. And the thing is, me, I've been in the business for 10 years. I'm not there yet, but guess what? I'm walking. I'm walking. It's like the rink is waiting for me. I just need to step, right? So always trust your journey. Do not ever, ever compare yourself to anyone that's been in the business. They came in and guess what? They went ambassador in 2 months, 2 years, 3 years. It doesn't matter. You stay the process. Your journey is your journey. This is your story, and it is being written by God, and trust Him. So, it took me 3 years, no, three, 4 years to go diamond. 4 years to go diamond. And I just never, it doesn't matter where my business is, how, I've had leaders leave. I remember Rachel, she's seen it all as well. I've had leaders leave and a mass exodus, and people have said, you just could come on this side because you're gonna get paid more, you're gonna get this more. I said, no, my feet is planted here, and I'm gonna be here. And I remember, I know I'm going all over, but I just know in my heart this is where I belong. I remember 1 year, I can't remember which year it was, and I was like, all the people were talking in my ears, come, come, come. And then I was listening to Pastor Todd, and he was like, I don't know who I'm talking to, but wherever you are, God told me to tell you wherever you are, here is holy, right? I'm sure Rachel remember that because she listens to Pastor Todd. And I was like, here is holy, right? So for me, where I am is holy. So no matter what is going on out there, where, who, what, I'm here. And I'm just so grateful. And when Rachel reached out to me and said, Merlene, I want you to be a guest on the call, I was like, I was just so grateful because I just love to serve. I just want people to know that I just want to share the fact, because I know people are like, most people are comparing themselves to others, to leaders, to sidelines, to down. Do not compare. Trust your journey, trust your process. The only thing you need to do every single day is put your foot in front of one foot in front of the other, pray, give yourself lots of grace, and work your business. All right, so that's all it is.
Yes, work your business. So let's talk about working the business. Okay. So thank you for that. I didn't know a lot of that. I did not know that you were in social work. And maybe you told me that before, but I don't remember that you were in social work. And then of course, I do have a question though, when it comes to being from Haiti. Were you born in Haiti or were you born here?
I was born in Haiti, so I came here when I was about 10 years old. I grew up in Jersey, did all my schooling in Jersey, and then I met my husband while traveling. I think on spring break, one of the spring break we had in South Carolina. That's how I met my husband, and I didn't think it was gonna work, but it worked out, and we're still together. We have three children. Oh, I forgot to share that. My baby, my third baby, took me to diamond and up. When I got pregnant, when I got pregnant with him, I just kept sharing. Just like when Rachel was pregnant with Zoe, she just kept sharing her journey. And I just kept sharing because I didn't use the products until my third baby. I did not, because when I first joined, I just had the baby and then I got pregnant again. So when I lost the weight, well, I used the products to lose 50 pounds. That's when, like, that's how I went diamond. And up.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay, so you're saying that it wasn't until you started using the products that you started to promote.
Yes, exactly.
Let's talk about that. Talk about that journey.
Yeah, and it's not like I wasn't enrolling, but People saw my journey. They saw the fact that I was pregnant. I gained the 50 pounds and I kept going live. And I say, here's the baby. Look how big I am. And then this is the product that I'm using. And then that's how they're like, oh my God, yes, I've seen the process. I've seen you share. Like I used to go live almost every single day, faithfully, just to show people. And I didn't know what I was doing. I was just sharing the products. And then one thing though, although I didn't use the products while I was pregnant or anything, I was excited. People saw my excitement. I was enrolling like crazy, didn't promote, but I kept enrolling. They saw my excitement, but I was sharing a lot of people results. I was like, listen, you guys, these results are amazing. I didn't even use the products. These results are amazing. This is a testament from my customers. This is a testament from my upline and all of that. I was excited. People know when you are real. People can see. They can see your excitement. They can see your like everything. So, and they can see if you're faking it. You know what I mean? So you gotta be real. Please, I'm there. Please go.
Stop being mean. Well, while she's talking, like that is real. Like, drop a one in the comments if using the products has signed you a customer. I know for me personally, that's one of the easiest ways to sign customers is to share. I was sending the pictures and the coins. So if you'll share your own personal journey, that's automatically going to get people to say yes to what it is that you're doing. And so, yes. All right. So let's get into the good stuff. Okay. You have had some overcome seasons in your business. So I want you to think right now about one of the toughest seasons that God brought you out of when it came to your business and how you got over to the other side.
Oh my God, so many, but I can clearly say the last 2 years, 2022, was it 2022, 2023 was the hardest year in my business. So from 2016 to I think 2020. Yeah. So I was with my old account. And then so I went ahead and decided, so I went to my first account, I took that to Double Diamond. And then I went ahead and re-enrolled. And I took the account again. It took me about 4 months to go ahead and get back to Double. And then the leader that I was with decided it was time for her to leave the company and wanted me to leave as well. And I'm like, I'm not gonna go through another leave. I'm not gonna go through, you know, all of that. I'm just gonna just keep staying. So in my heart, God was telling me, like, I am like, what is that song? I think it's Tasha Cobbs when she says that God will strip you all the way to the low, and then we're gonna bring you back up. So, and I kept thinking to myself, like, I went all the way down to executive from Double Diamond all the way down to executive. I think it was August 2023. And although that I went all the way down, what is $300, you know? And it's not I wasn't working. It was just that season. But I just kept trusting God. I kept trusting God. And I had one of my sideline sisters that I work with. I don't know if she's on here, Yatika. And I just kept telling her, I'm like, I don't know what I'm going to do. She's like, you're just going to have to just trust. God will not leave you high and dry. Just trust the process. You've been trusting for this long. Just keep trusting. So, and I was like, okay, I'm just going to keep trusting. Oh, Yatika. So I'm like, I'm just gonna keep trusting. And then so August of 2023, I was down executive. And then my leader, and she had reached out to me. She said God put in her heart, she was enrolling someone. She said God put in her heart to go ahead and enroll this person and place that person under me. That was August. And then that whole leg is just took off. It took off. Took off. So I'm running as well. I did. Okay. I'm like, okay, let's run. So I started running back and then got me. Then re-rank. I was able to earn my trip. I was able to earn bonuses, and it was just like, oh my God, how? Like, I don't know, but it's just from that moment, I just knew that no matter how it looks like, you just got to keep going. Just keep trusting your process. You're going, listen, you are going to lose people. You're going to pe not lose. God just makes way. That's all. He just takes people out to bring people in order for you to be where you're supposed to be. So don't ever feel like, oh my God, this leg is not working. That person's not working. One thing that I learned is if you have a distributor's account and there are people under in your organization, their account is active, they working. Because guess what? You can use that leg, right, to fill that up. If they're running their auto shipment, if that's all they can do, they're working. If they can just enroll one customer, they are working. Never ever say nobody's working on my team. Never ever say that I don't have a working team. No, you're going to be grateful, appreciate who you have, work with who you have around you. Just meet them where they are. Have lots of grace because people are going through stuff. You just never know. Just give people grace.
That is so good and so true. Like, hands down, like, people are going through things and just learning to move in a space of gratitude, and God will just see you through. It's crazy how just God comes see. I always say God knows exactly what you need, and when you need it, you have to trust Him. And also just the pruning process. And so tell me, in the midst of that time, what are the three things, maybe three to five things that, oh, I'll say three, that you learned about yourself? What did you learn about yourself in the midst of that process?
Well, the one thing about me, because of what I've been through as far as like my fertility journey, so I trusted the fact that God allowed me to have children. If He allowed me to have children, like what else? It's same God, exactly. The same God that allowed me to have children, the same God that allowed me to double ruby, executive ruby, emerald, diamond, double. It's the same God that's going to take me where I need to be in the next season. The other thing is just being resilient and never have like, I remember when that last leader left, and I cried so much because I felt in my heart that, like, why, God, why? And then one of my other sideline sisters just kept saying, "This is making more room for you. What are you doing? Why are you crying?" It's just gonna make more room for you to just walk into your purpose. Like, don't worry about that. God takes people away. He's not taking people. He's just making room. Just making room. So I learned to just like be faithful. Just the same God that did what He did is the same God that's gonna like just bring me higher.
That's good. I remember a conversation that we had, and that was in, where were we at? Where was we?
Punta Cana.
Punta Cana. We were in Punta Cana. You remember that conversation? What was it?
We talked a lot, but I know like one thing that you kept saying, like, if you're not, like, if you, some of the things that I was stopping myself and I was holding on. And at that time, I was holding on to people. I was holding on to the fact that, like, even people on my social media, why are they on my space? Why? Cut it loose. I remember that.
No, that's good. No, I'm listening. Yeah, like, it was the getting focused. How do you realign your focus? Because when you go through a bad season, you really, where your focus goes, grows. But you had to shift your focus and be in this place, and you can hear it now. You're in this space of gratitude. You're in this space of growth. You're in this space of trusting God. You're in this space of faith. And as a result, God is delivering. You know what I'm saying? Like, He is coming through for you. And so, what would you say, when it comes to your day-to-day interaction and what you do to build your business, what are you doing today, like right now in this season, to build your business?
Sure. And before I forget, I wanted to share too a part of this testimony. And at that time when I was going through it, I'm like, oh my God, this is it. I earned that trip to Jamaica. I didn't go because I couldn't afford it.
Did we talk about that?
I couldn't afford it because I worked the business, I earned a trip. Because I think I remember what point system that they used, but I earned it. But at that time, it financially was not a good idea to go. And I fought and fought with my husband, like, we earned a trip. I gotta go. And then I talked to my mentor. She was like, your blessing will not miss you, okay? There's gonna be much more opportunities. If you're not able to go, yes, you earned it. Be grateful that you earned it and keep going. But some people would have give up if they, you know what I mean? But I'm like, no, I'm not gonna give up, But day to day, this is what I do. Every single morning I get up, I have my prayer room right there, my prayer closet. This is where I journal. I get up at 5 o'clock in the morning, I journal, and then I pray. After I'm done praying, I go on my, I opened up, I spend time, after I spend time with the Lord, I opened up my social media by engaging, sending everybody a happy birthday. I search Facebook, I send the people who celebrating their birthday a happy birthday. Then after that, I prepare for my posts, I prepare for my slides and my stories, things that I'm gonna put in my Teams chat and things like that. I do that. Once I'm done with that, I only do host to post. Like, I don't do anything else for that time. I just do my host to post. Host to post, for those of you who are new, it's basically asking people to post for you on their social media. That way it opens up their network to you. Okay, you ask them to post for you. So I send about, everybody have their numbers. So for me, my number, in order for me to get 5 to 10 people to post for me, I have to ask about 50 to 60. Sometimes it takes 100 to get my 10, and sometimes, it's, but most of the time, that's the minimum I have to send in order to get that. Then after that, 8 o'clock, we have a journal Zoom.
Okay, pause. Sorry, interjecting. Let's talk about the jail situation. You doing host the post on Instagram or
Just Facebook.
Facebook?
The
Okay.
jail situation, the way to get out of that, is by engaging. Before I do, did I say engage? Yeah, I engage for so when I first get, I engage 25 people before I send any messages.
And when
25
you say
people.
engage, what are you doing?
I'm commenting. I go on my friends list. Thank you for asking. I go on my friends list and then pick a friend and then start engaging. And then I see who mutual friends that I have with that person. And then I go to our mutual friends and then go ahead and engage and engage and engage and engage. And then if I can't find anyone else on there, I keep finding like mutual friends from that person. I engage, engage, engage. But I use 4 comments. Oh my God, you look so great. Where did you get that dress? Or happy birthday. Hope you have the best day. Like, pretty much 4 words, at least 4. That's how I've been staying out of jail.
So engaging is really important before, okay, because sis go to jail all the time. So I'm
Got
trying it tomorrow. Well, not tomorrow because I'm off Thursday. I'm trying it Thursday. I'll come back to you, tell you how that goes. So everybody, write that in. You're going to engage and you go from friends to friends. I see you. What's your Rebel tab? I don't know what your name is, but I see you.
Right.
So you're gonna go from friend to friend. So you engage on that person's page, 4+ words. On one post, and then you would go to mutual friends, find your next person, and do 25. That's good.
25,
Thank you
and I
so much.
count. I count. And before I finish, I make sure I count
Good, you
because
got 25.
that's what
Awesome.
he got.
Okay, that's good.
I
Thank you.
did. So that's my first part of the morning, engaging in host to post. Second part of my morning, 8 o'clock, 8 to 8:30, I have a journal call, one of my sideline sister hosts. We are reading 100 days of Believing Bigger. But every time we finish a book, we go to the next one. 100 days of Believing Bigger, devotional journal. So we do that for 30 minutes. Then once I'm done with that, I go to the gym because that's part of working. All right. That's part of working. That's part of working when you're working out. But before I go to the gym, I do my son. If just have your daddy talk to them. So before I go to the gym, before journal, I take my slimmer, my aloe, and my greens. Slimmer, aloe, greens. Those are the three products I take before my day started. Then I go to the gym. After I go to the gym, when the kids are in school, I take them to school, whatever. But right now they're in summer, they still go to the gym with me. After I come back from the gym, between 10 and 12, that's when I am either cooking, going around with the kids, and also in between, I do my story slides and things. Once I'm done with that, midday, after they eat their lunch, I go back to work. Working is basically responding to HAP. Now I'm sent I have I engage again before I start sending my messages, responding to HAPs, and then sending my 25, my number is 25, 25 p.m. 25 product messages, asking them to be my customer, 25 distributor messages, and then I do my 25 follow-ups. All right. So that's midday. So that's like 12 to 1, 12 to 1-ish. Then after that, the kids again. That's my schedule summer. Then, I deal with the kids. Around 3 o'clock, I go back to work. About 3 to 4, I go back to work responding. Then my husband come home, make sure he has dinner with the kids, all of that. And then I come back to work at 7:30, 7:30 to 9:30. It's not good.
So it's clocking in. So I've
Yeah.
heard this concept before. It's imperative to like clock in, especially when people are working full time, the business full time, taking the time to clock in, blocking your time, and then also knowing. And one of the things I love about what you said is that you send messages at the beginning of the day, and then you can worry about follow-ups, and you can worry about reach outs, but you're not concerned about post the post because you've already done it. And then also follow-ups can get you host the post up as well. So that's really good. It's a nice system. Yes, absolutely. So I have another question. Say somebody who is working a full-time job, and what would you say is the most important thing for them to do in order to be successful in this season of business? What would be the most important thing that you would tell somebody who's working a full-time job to do daily to build their business?
I would say to if you work 9 to 5, right? I would say sacrifice and wake up at 5. Sacrifice and wake up at 5. If you wake up at 5, you do the same thing. Like spend about 15 minutes or earlier, right? Do about 15 minutes or 20 minutes, and then once you all of the tasks, most of them take about 5 to 10 minutes. I promise you. It takes about five, like my host to post, the most that it takes is 10 minutes. You could do 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, like everything in 10. And then you spend that hour and you finish. And then in the evening again, if you tell like school time, like I said, for me, this is what I do. I clock in for my 5 to 6. And then I take care of kids. I do all of that. When I'm with my kids, I don't have my phone. Like it's, I gotta put it down. And then, but it's something that took me about 3 years to learn. So I have to tell you guys, this schedule here, it took me about 3 years in the business to learn. So you gotta give yourself time, because sometimes I could be telling you this, it doesn't click until Rachel say it 2 years later. Or who's on here? Like it's like anybody else, I like, could say it 3 years later. Lorraine, Miss Lorraine could say, like, it doesn't click, but for me, like I just know I have my schedule, this is my schedule, and then like around 8, between now, this is when I'm signing my customers. I always sign my customers late in the evenings. I'm going my auto, I'm doing my auto shipment. I'm, you know, messaging my my current customer and say, hey, your order ship is running, da da da, you know, things like that. So as long as like you tell your day where to go, like if you get up at 5, don't waste time on social media. Don't do that. You're defeating the purpose. So just know that, okay, yeah, I'm here to work. I'm gonna work my five, my hour and then go to work. Put your phone down. If they're messaging you, this is not the time. You at work. Always know that you at work. When you finish working, then work your business. When you get home, if you have to make dinner, make your dinner. Do all the things that you need to do. And then an hour before you go to sleep, go ahead and respond. Nobody's gonna die. Nobody's gonna say, oh my God, no, you're not gonna lose anything. Your blessings will not miss you. All right. You just respond and then just know if they're for you, they are for you. Nobody's going anywhere. So a lot of people did just like, oh my God, I gotta respond right now. I gotta, no, you don't. It's okay. It is okay. And like I said, took me 3 years. And because it took me 3 years, it's not gonna take you 3 years. All right. We are telling you, we are we are just letting you know, just work. Like you can, even if you work two jobs, you can still work this business. You, because we have 24 hours. You have lunch break, you have a 10-minute break, you have 15 minutes break, you have 30. Just use your time wisely if you're working.
Good. That's so good. Use your time wisely and like owning your time instead of allowing your time to own you. So, what the question I had a question based on something that you said. Oh man, it's come back to me. I'm gonna have to go to the next question. Oh, okay. So signing your customers. How do you sign your customers? What is your process for signing customers?
So one thing you have to be, you got to be consistent. You got to be consistent. So for me, the schedule that I have, like I have stuff, like I have things in my stories. I post, I do reels, I do my hostel post. I ask. Posting is not asking. You have to ask. And then I started recently. I forgot. I just, I have my flowers in the kitchen. I started passing out flyers around my neighborhood for sip and sample. Yes, I did. Oh my God. Oh my God. I started passing flyers around my neighborhood for, so prayfully is that's gonna work. But I've been literally, I used to do parties when I had a, I have a girl on here, Tasha. We used to do parties all the time back in 2016, and then we got away from that, but we're getting back to it. So me signing customers is literally one of the ways that I sign customers you won't believe is like when I post like my family pictures or some like vacation or things like that. So when I get a lot of comments or likes, I ask them, I say, hey, thank you so much for your social support. Oh, let me put them, I could put messages on here, right? The chat. I put messages on here like, pretty much, thank you so much for your social support. I was just wondering, would it be okay if I send you a list of the products that we have, and if you see anything that you like, you know, I can guide you. Something like that. I'll look for the message and I'll put it in the chat. So I asked them that. So those are the people that usually post for me. People that that usually I ask them to be a customer or a distributor. And the other way that I sign customers when I do my hostel post, I put my number. So let's say I'm doing hostel post for a cleanse, right? I said text cleanse to, you know, my friend Merlane, 864-367. And then whatever that what if I say cleanse or drop, so they'll text me. So that's one way of signing customers. Oh, I don't mind sharing my number.
So do you do number opposed to comment below?
No, I put my number. No, they don't
Right.
have
So
my
do
number.
you do your number? So you don't tell them, you do your number instead of having them comment on the post.
Yeah, I put my number on the,
And
I put.
typically do And you get a lot, you get text messages.
A lot of text messages, like either
Instant.
clearance, drop, or the opportunity. I always put my number. I always put my number on there. So I get a lot of customers from there. And then following up every single day. Remember I told you I do my 25 follow-ups? So following up. So when I follow up, like right now we have a special with the TFX. So this is the message that I send. So to them, I
If you
just
want to text it to me, I can put it in there. Or you can drop it, whichever one is easier.
me see if it's gonna drop. I don't think it's gonna drop. Oh no, it's not gonna drop. I'm gonna text it to you.
Yeah, I'll share it.
So
And
yeah,
are
so
you calling them or are you sending links for them to sign up?
I'm old school. I do call.
Good. No, good. But yeah. Do you just
I call because I just don't. Most people are like, there's no urgency. They don't have to get the product right now, so they're like, I'll wait. No, we're getting on the phone. This is why I have them text me, and I'm like, okay, are you free to talk now? So I just call them. Like everybody's my friend. Everybody's your friend or family. Like I'm friendly anyway. So they like easy to give me their information. Soon as we get on the phone, and I said, and you don't have to rush. I know some people say selling points is rushing. Not me. Not me. I let them talk. I let them tell me their whole story about why or how, everything. They tell me everything. And I just try to like relate to them. I say, yeah, and I give them my attention. And boom, that's how I sound like I said.
so good. It's relationships. It's connecting with people, and so that's really good. I'm gonna give you a second so you can send me these messages so I can share them with you.
I'm just gonna text you,
So
Rachel.
for as you're sending this to we best friends, yeah, so I said yeah, besties. So what would you say to the person who has just signed up and is send me the other one too. I know you said there was two messages that you. Yep. What would you say to the brand new distributor who is on here and is getting started, just getting started? What would you say to them? What word of encouragement would you have for them?
I would say that, don't be fearful. Don't be afraid. Don't think about what are people gonna think, because it's not gonna pay your bills at all. Go all in. Go all in, like literally, and learn as much as you can. But don't worry if you don't know it all. A lot of people are afraid, like, well, I don't know what I'm talking about. All you have to do, just pull up your website if somebody has a question, and then just read it. Like, you're the expert. And I know so many people are so fearful of what others are thinking. Oh, I don't want to bother anyone. Always know that we have the best products out here. We really do. Okay, we have the best products out here. And have faith in God, have faith in yourself, have faith in the company. I mean, this company, like Rachel and I, we've been here for so long, and we're still here. They have not done us wrong at all. They help us. Okay, so they got this company literally have your back. I could go on and on about how, like, I've been in situation and I'm like, oh my God, I think I'm about to lose my account because no, they have your back. They're gonna work with you. And so just trust that. Take some time to go to the It Works app and learn the app. Like, it takes about 40 minutes. If you don't have time, 10 minutes a day for 4 days. That's it. And if you don't have 10 minutes, 5 minutes a day for a few more days. And and then if you feel alone, it's because you want to be alone. Because you have a community here, whether you're white, black, Asian, whatever, we want you to succeed. So don't ever feel like you have no support. You have us to support you, because you're gonna go through sometimes you're gonna go through a season where I know you're gonna feel alone, But don't, that's just the enemy telling you that you're alone, but you're not. Because once you reach out to any of us, I could reach out to anybody on here. I think I met Wania at the airport. I saw you at the airport. And when we were, where were we? Bradenton, right? So it's just like, I just knew, like and I talked to her. So anybody, you can reach out to anybody in the company, they will help you. Not I'm saying like, of course, there are good and bad people everywhere. You're gonna find that, but for the most part, you're going to find at least one person that's gonna help you. So don't ever feel alone. Just and post. You can be, I remember when I first joined, I was ignorance on fire. I didn't care what I was posting, how I was posting, and I was just posting. Just keep posting. And it's like you cannot like basically, oh my God, I cannot post this. So, yes, just go ahead. Just go. Post whatever you want, as long as you're not cursing, you're not, just post. All content is content, you know? So that's what I would tell a
That's
newbie.
so good. I would it's easier to steer a car that's driving. I'll say that. And so when the car is driving, it's easier to steer it than to try to get a car to go. Then it's not on the road. So that's so good. What about, I got two more questions. What would you say to the person who is where you were in 2022? What would you say to them?
Don't give up. Don't give up. Just no, just pray. Like really go to God. Go to God. I remember I was on the stairs and just like crying to God, like, where are you? But he was right there. He was right there. He was just, you know, taking me through that season just to just to humble me and to know that, like, you know, you can't do this by yourself, that he's got you. Just and don't think that it's greener on the other side. It's not. You just have to keep watering what you have. You have to keep posting. You have to keep messaging. You have to keep asking. I know some days you're like, I don't want to, but just do it anyway. One more, like Mark always say, just send one more message. One more message, just one more. Like, just don't give up. Like, I'm so glad I didn't give up in 2022 or 2023. I'm so glad when I saw my check, my commissions, and I was just like, God, how, what am I gonna do with this? But I just know that you will provide, and he did. I'm still here. Like, I still have a roof over my head. My children are able to eat. You know, my, I know, like, we're still here. You know, and we made it. So just don't give up. Keep going. Yes, Sasha. Still, yeah, we're still here.
That is so sweet. That is so sweet. We got a question. Do you work 7 days a week?
I used to, but God kept telling me to take a Sabbath, so I so I'm taking my Sabbath.
On, talk about this because everybody in here don't take Sabbath. That look, just because people on my team, you would think they take a Sabbath, but that don't mean that. So go ahead and talk about it.
So I've been like, I used to take a Sabbath like faithfully. Then I started working out of desperation. Is that,
Desperation, a
yeah,
thousand
that's the word.
percent.
Right. And then God is like, and nothing was moving. What are you doing?
Jesus.
So I took a Sabbath this past Sunday, and it was crazy. You know, I was like, I'm doing 6 to 6, 6 Saturday evening until 6 the following Sunday. And it just felt so good. And then Monday, I got an order for like, what was it, 300 BV? I was
Fine. Won't he do it? Won't he do it?
oh, yeah, please take a Sabbath. But some people were like, well, I'm gonna take my Sabbath. Did you work? You gotta make sure you work, put in the work, and then make sure you take your side, like work your business. And like I said, for me, I know people say you can get burnout and this and that. You know, just give yourself grace. Give people grace. Give people grace. Let people be, because they go through some things. Don't feel like this team is, no, don't worry about that. Just Mind what you're supposed to be doing. Okay, what are you supposed to be doing? You're supposed to be praying, right? You're journaling and praying. You're going to engage. You're going to do your hosted posts. You're going to post. You're going to post your reels. You're going to do your messaging. And there's four types of messaging: hosted posts, customer, distributors, and follow-up. Just do those. If you can't do 25, do 5 a day. Do 5 a day. Because that adds up, right? Right. I'm not a math. I know Rachel's better in math, but like just 5. Just do those and stay consistent. Pick your number, do them, and stay consistent, and then take your Sabbath.
Listen, you already know how I feel about the
I
Sabbath.
know.
It is what it is. It's so funny. I was on a call the other day and they were like, "What they were, it's for a woman at the well, you know, where we read one chapter of the Bible a day." And she, you know, Amber got on there and was like, "Everybody needs to take a Sabbath." And I'm sitting here like, people like, it might be rough in the beginning. I'm like, baby, ain't nothing rough about my Sabbath. Where is Wednesday? I am coming for you. It's my favorite day of the week. Why? Because I am able to rest in him like never before and say, God, I put in the work these past 6 days and I am trusting you with my business because I would rather my business be in his hands than in my hands. Okay, I want my business in his hands, not in my hands. And then also knowing that that day is coming where I'm going to take a day off, I know I need to put in the work. I used to put up 10 hosted posts before I would go out on my Sabbath so that I would come back on Thursday with so many messages. I wanted to come back on Thursday with so many messages. On Wednesday, it's not they, they're still gonna be interested on Thursday. They still need the products on Thursday. They still need, like, it doesn't go away now because I'm working more in person. I don't do that. But yes, so good. All right, last thing. What is next for you? And
Next
I would
is
say this, d ranks, dreams, visions, like when it comes to your It Works business, the dreams and visions that you have for your family, your team, what's next?
cutting that net, cutting the
What does that mean for you?
net. going ambassador, so next,
Why?
the first next is getting to VIP. Which is triple. I am 3 distributors away.
Let's
Yeah.
go.
And then, of course, the volume. And then, yeah, going ambassador, cutting that net. Just like I can just see 15 diamonds on my team. Like,
Why ambassador? Why?
oh my gosh. Like, that's the finish line from for me. It's not like the finish, but it works. Just reaching that, seeing me from like pretty much bottom, all the way from the bottom, from 2014 until whenever. Like, I don't know when. It could be tomorrow, it could be whoever, whenever. It's just like the freedom, the financial freedom, the impact that I will have in my organization, in my community, and like basically my world. I'm from Haiti and I have people counting on me, and people are watching me. I remember when John called me on stage. I was so shocked. I was like,
So
when
cool.
he called me on stage and literally and spoke these words over my life, saying that like I will be like a world changer, like for my community, and just bringing my community, for them to see, what this product or the company. And I always lead, like, it's not just about selling, it's the impact that we'll have on, people are, going to be making $500 on my team, $1,000, $10,000, $15,000. It's that's what I want. I want to see others win, from the team. So, and then like all of you are pushing for me, and I'm doing it for you all, because I know you guys are like, oh my God, she's gonna make it. She's gonna make it.
It's so good. It's always good to know that somebody is rooting for you and has your back. And so that's so special. That's special. Okay, anything that lacks that you would like to say to everybody who's on, but to the squad, what are your last words or anything that God has on your heart?
Pretty much just So the squad trusts Rachel's leadership and do what she says. She's there up there for a reason. She's paved the way for all of us and everybody else. Like, yeah, definitely attach yourself with people, with positive people, okay? People that are that see the vision, people who believe in you. If you have someone that's pushing you, stay close to them, okay? And you guys just continue to do the work and like I said before, put God first, believe in him. He will bless your the hands of your work. He will bless it. So that's all I have to say.
He will bless the hands of your work. Won't he do it? I received that. That is so good. Well, thank you so much for your time. I feel so blessed to know you and to just be a small part of everything that you've done here at It Works. And it's just been a blessing to see you grow. And I know that you haven't even really gotten started yet. And I just see you taking people to heights that they didn't know that they could experience. And in every moment that you have doubted or that you've doubted yourself or questioned yourself, your willingness to fight is blessing so many people. And so I just appreciate you for loving on us tonight. And I know people will be watching the replay later. And I just pray that God gives you your time back a hundredfold. And we are praying for you. Okay, let's go, Triple Diamond. That's exciting. I'm praying that you close the boxes out and that you and your team rank in all the bonuses in Jesus' name. So go, would you go ahead and pray us out and then we'll get off of here. Thank you so much for doing this tonight.
Oh, thank you. And thank you so much for like this is such an honor. Thank you for our team, our organization that's here. I'm so grateful to all of you. I'm so grateful Amber, she's took me under her wings. I don't know if she's on here, but I just want to thank her as well. I mean, that lady, man, she, I think she believes in me more than I believe in myself. And that's all the leaders. Like, seriously, that's all of us. We believe in you all more than you believe in yourself because we see it, you know? So, yeah, I pray you guys out. Father God, thank you for this day. Thank you. Just thank you, God, for allowing us to just be among your people and to be in your presence. God. And as you said before, that here, wherever we are, is holy. We pray for anybody on the call right now that's going through a tough time in their business, in their lives. God, we ask that you just touch them and give them the peace that passes all understanding. Just let them feel your presence. Just let them feel the joy that they need. Lord, and because the plan that you have for us is for us to be successful, plans for us to prosper, and just let them know that you have that for them, God. We believe in you, Lord. We pray for our company. We pray for the leaders in the company. Thank you, God, for Rachel. Please continue to send a special blessing on her, on her team. God, we pray these things that you would bless the words that we spoke. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Thank you. Everybody
Thank
have a
you,
good
God.
night.
You too. Thank you.
Bye. Thank you.